All right, I'm back, and I'm gonna leave this wrapped up for a moment. If you remember last time, I just cleaned up all my box after I had cut the top off. And we'll look at that in a minute. But at this point, or if you remember in the last video, it was kind of about ready to, if I didn't wanna do anything else with it, it was ready to dry and be bisque fired. But in this case, I want to start carving on it. And so let me just go over some examples of some carving. This is just, the glaze job, as you can, isn't that great, but this is just a piece that was left behind in, that was left behind here. And they kind of carved some designs in that that kind of followed the way the top was cut, so I think that's pretty cool. And this student, he had an even better example of one of these, but this is just an example of carving kind of in the same spirit as the lines that you use to cut your top. And I'll be going over some tools that can be used for carving, not the knife. But I want to show you, a lot of students, they want to carve with a needle tool because it's so easy to move around. But the problem with that is that the lines are just too fine. And here's an example of a student who used a needle tool, again, another piece that was left behind. And if you can see, our final treatment is glaze. That's pretty much all we have in this studio. And other techniques where you can use underglaze, which is like, you know, using a colored slip. Maybe you could get away with making fine lines like this by, say, using a white clay and then putting a layer of red slip on it and then scratching away. It's called sgraffito, scratching away the small thin layer of red clay to reveal the white clay underneath. But since we have glaze, you can see that, you can actually see it that it's white, so it's not good still. But you know, glaze fills in some spots and sometimes doesn't fill in other spots. And so it just doesn't turn out very good. And in this particular, if the glaze was dark glaze, in this case it's white, then it'd look even worse because these parts would be completely, the parts that the glaze filled in would be completely invisible, but you'd see these empty spots. So do not carve with the needle tool. Okay, that's the point of that. All right, the tools you do carve with are typically loop tools. These are some typical examples. You have a triangular shape over here and a more loop over here. This is about the same size triangle, but this kind of this shape over here. You have the big one to take out, remove a lot of clay at a time. Big loop tool. Another one with a perfect circle and the same size triangle. Another loop tool. Knife's not a loop tool. Here's some, a dry brush to brush away any pieces that you carve away. That's helpful. Here's a tool that's half needle and kind of half of this, a cleanup tool. If you look up on this one here, this one actually says cleanup on it, cleanup tool on it. And this is for, I guess, general cleanup when you're scraping away all those little crumbs and little pieces of debris, we call it, off of your piece. But this can be used to carve. And I guess even this, really small things, and we will be working pretty small, so I think I'm gonna use this for one of mine. And the main loop tools right here, these you can check out, and they come in a set of six. You have three kind of circular tools. Let me get the circular tools going. Oh, this one doesn't. You should have three circular tools like this one. And then three more triangular tools. And I think, I'm pretty sure it's three circles and three triangles here, but this case, this set is not complete, not correct, but it's here anyways. So I don't have much time right now, so this video might be pretty choppy. Again, you don't have to watch every minute of it, but do watch this first part. Here's my piece. I'm gonna start carving just this top surface here. And so I'm not gonna unwrap this just yet. And in fact, I probably need to wet these paper towels so they've dried up in the past few days. But let me show you what my idea is. When it comes to the sides, I think I'm gonna do some carving like this with small loop tools to, remember I had like that wave in it. I'll probably continue with that, the waviness of there. But for the top, I think I'm gonna put a kind of Day of the Dead skull on it. And this is the first one I print. These are just printouts from Google Images. And I'm kind of thinking, let's see. I printed out two sizes to see which one fits best. This one fits 70% because that's what I printed it at. And then I print out this one here at 60%. 70% one might work. Let me get some scissors. Of course, you could also freehand carve, which is what I'm gonna do on the sides, but this is just an idea of how to transfer something from paper, from a printout or a drawing that you did, onto the clay so you can print out. I'm basically gonna not necessarily outline it, but just press in. I think the 70% will work just fine. I'm gonna kind of reveal this whole thing so I can, or at least the top part, so that I can get an idea of where to put this. I could measure it. Is that about centered? About centered. I pull it up from the bottom. And to transfer, I just want the lines. I don't want all this detail in there. Probably not. I don't think I could quite have the patience or the time to do that. But this feels pretty firm. If it didn't feel firm, I would take off the top, because I don't want to press the top in, especially if it's soft. We'll take off the top, and I would put something in here to back it, because if I put pressure on it when I'm drawing or carving on it, I don't want the top to cave in. In this case, again, I feel like this is pretty firm. I don't think it'll cave in. But if you're concerned about that, you can get a piece of paper or paper towel and put it in here, and then maybe get a chunk of recycled clay and make a little block that'll fit in there so that you could rest it. Of course, it would have to protrude out longer than your lid. And then you could have that as support so that you wouldn't push this in. And I might as well demonstrate that. So I'm gonna go get some recycled clay. A couple chunks from the recycle bin, and let me just look at this over here. Again, I don't want this to dry out. Something to consider is I don't want this to dry out faster than this in here. Remember, I have to get those crumbs out when it gets a little drier. Let's see. That's clean. Just gonna press this so it's it can fit in this space here. So just a little bit more. I'm gonna press it against the board to make it flat. Just make both sides flat. Make sure that's parallel. Then I don't want this clay to stick to this clay, so I need to get a piece of paper. About this one. See, it could be a little more narrow. It's okay if it comes out over here, it'll be easier to pull out. And I can use this knife to chop off this extra part. A little too long. Because I want my skeleton just right in the middle, I'm not so concerned with getting this all the way edge to edge. And I think this would work anyways. So this block in here, I need to carefully lift this up, or I can just even lift this up. Lift them up separately. And that there, as you can see there, there's my temporary block goes down past my side on this side. And this side, ooh, it's kind of close, but let's see if we can make it work. When I put it on the table, yes, there's some clearance just under there, so I won't be putting any pressure on that part of the lid. Actually, let me look at this to make sure I kind of assign my front side. That looks pretty good as a front. Let's look at this side. This side has that little finger press mark. So I'm gonna make that the back. So if this is the front, then I want it to be oriented this way. So I'm just gonna put this down right here. And I've gotta get going pretty soon. I'm gonna use that 70% one. And I could either measure or eyeball where center is. And let's see if I have a ruler here. Might as well get closer to center. 0, it's 5 1/4. So half of 5 is 2 1/2, half of 1 1/4 is 1 8. 2 1/2 and 1 8 is right there. Is that right? No, I have it at 2 1/2, exactly. So I want 2 1/2 and 1 8, which is right there. I'll have to go in and I can erase that a little bit better later. So I'm looking at the nose and the center mark and the center chin mark. So say about there. I have my pencil and I'm just gonna press into the outline. Press pretty firmly, depends on how firm or soft your clay is. Oops, went off a little bit. If this isn't perfect, you can always just get a little bit of water on your finger and erase it. Take that much of the cheekbone. And if it's not firm enough, you can come back in and, you know, erase it with a little bit of water on your finger. And I don't think I'm gonna, pay attention to like the details, like the eyes and the mouth and nose. But I don't think I'll pay attention to the other really fine details in here. You can if you want. Through. Oops, there's a bell. I gotta get going. Get the eyes. The nose. Let's see, I'll kind of make approximate the teeth for the mouth. All right. Yeah, let's see, I think that's all for now. There's that needle tool. I can just use any of these tools here. Oh, there's a needle tool just to lift off. I don't know if you can see that. I have just a very I have an outline of what I want to make, and I'm gonna wrap this up for now and continue another time. today is 1-2-1-2-4-6.
Oh, so you don't have our classes?
No, I think it's, yeah, 1-2-4-6 advisory.
You should?
Kind of special.
I thought you had our classes today.
No, because we should have done that on Friday, but we didn't. Yeah, so go to second period. Yeah. I think it's still second period, and then I won't see you till Wednesday.
What's the fans?
Yeah. Whose class are you coming from? Yes, it's in the email about the schedule for today or for this week, actually. I don't think it's. I think it's 1-2-4-6 today. All right. But if not, I'll see you in a little bit.
Skipping.
Hello.
Am I interrupting you?
I'm just working on this.
Oh, cool. So I had a question about Andrew Torres. He's in
right.
Third. Is there any way he could take work to do it out of here?
No, not Clay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just doesn't. Even if.
I'm just gonna make him sit over here away from the girls.
Okay. Yeah. It's what he says. You know, priorities are like preferential seating, but if you guys see fit anything.
He says, "Oh, I'm just too distracted in there." I'm like, "Well, go sit away from the girls."
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And he doesn't want to work with Clay. I mean, we went through this last semester too, but.
Yeah. Is he triggered by it, you think, or?
I don't know. I just don't think he wants to do anything. Lazy. Yeah, yeah. I think so, too. And by the way, your AirPod turned up. Go to my desk.
Oh, okay.
Someone found it on the floor last week.
That was Jeremiah's.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, well, we'll go over there and ask, and we just didn't make it, and then.
Well, I saw your email, but then in the middle of the week, someone just, hey, this was on the floor. Well, yeah, he was here last week, and he and the other guy walked out because I guess they know. I was sitting right there too, like right in front of him. They just,
yeah.
I guess when you're not here, they just
even when I am.
Oh yeah, they stole the walk out. Okay. Care. Yeah. Okay.
Whatever. I mean, Jeremiah's kind of come out of his shell a little bit. He's trying to do work in other classes. I'm happy when he just comes to class.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's not disruptive as long as
right.
he's not being disruptive.
Yeah, well, that's the first step, but then they need to get stuff done.
I know, I'm not a creative kid, you know, it's just...
Is he?
Yeah, he can be.
Okay.
Can be. Awesome. Good, thanks, good. Mr. King.
All right, thanks. All right, let's go. Let's start with the red. Oh, I guess you can start here, but we'll bring the red over.
sorry for the interruption. This is just a reminder to everybody that on today's schedule, we will have a 30-minute advisory today because there's a lot of information on pre-registration and stuff that needs to take place today. So in the schedule that was sent out to you, it says assembly. It's not an assembly, it's your advisory. So we need everybody to report to your advisory teachers during that time. And again, today's advisory will be a little bit longer than normal. It'll be 30 minutes on that. Also for staff, I know a lot of you got an email about having to do surveillance testing. And some of you are indicating that you've already completed that. What we do need you to do is come into the main office and see Mrs. Springer and myself, and do bring in your laptop because you will have to log in so we can double check exactly how it was submitted, because survey is very sensitive on the information. If you didn't put anything right, you got kicked out automatically. So if you got a surveillance testing memo and you know you're up to date with your vaccines and your booster, please come and see Ms. Springer and myself so we get that corrected and we can get it submitted so we can take you off that list for right now. So again, if you do have to do that, come and see Mrs. Springer and myself on that one. Everybody have a great day, and we'll be seeing everybody here shortly in your advisory class. Thank you and have a good day.